Hello, the web-free bug I will show you today is absolutely insane. Almost like I could tell you to give me some money and it would be directly transferred from your wallet to mine. That's why the bounty for it was the equivalent of $1 million. And we'll have the bug explained to us by someone with way better web-free skills than I. Lead offensive security engineer from Halborn, Michał Bajor. Enjoy. Hello, Michał. Thank you so much for joining me to explain the bug. The bug was in the process of exchanging the tokens, different kinds of tokens. Could you talk us through what tokens were there? Were they?
Sure. Hi, Greg. Thanks for having me. Basically, you have near specific tokens, which are called NEP 141 compatibles. And then you have ERC20 tokens, which exist in the Aurora blockchain that implements basically an Ethereum-like network. And you have a token on your side, and you want to transfer it to the Aurora. And you can. There is a process for this, and the vulnerability we'll be talking about was found exactly in this process.
So could you show us the code? How did it look like normally without messing up things yet?
Absolutely. Yeah, so NEP 141 tokens on the near side are specific because they contain an FT transfer call function, which performs a similar thing as an ERC20 approval, but with one transaction. It essentially means that you are transferring some tokens, and with this transfer, you want to call some function in some other contract. In this case, you would use this function, the FT transfer call, on a token that you want to send to the Aurora, and specify that this token should call Aurora contract in the process. And this is standardized, and in this case, the FT on transfer function will actually be called, which is the case here. Basically, there are arguments provided to this call. One of it is a message that will be very important soon. If everything goes smoothly, then you go into the receive ERC20 tokens in the Aurora contract, and this function looks like this. You basically parse this this message that you have here. But let me show you the vulnerable code, actually, not the one that contains the fixes. Yeah, the receive ERC20 tokens. It parses this message that's contained within the arguments, because this message contains information about the recipient address, and this is the address of the recipient on the Aurora network, and information about any fee that this person needs to pay for this transaction. And this fee might, of course, be zero. You parse it, and then you check. The first 40 characters are related to the recipient. And if there is something after those characters, then this will be considered as a fee that needs to be paid. If this fee is not zero, in this case, you basically
fee the same? When I do a transaction via MetaMask, there is a pop-up about a fee of the transaction. Is this fee the same, or is this something different?
This is not the same fee, although they are related. The fee you're talking about is just the fee associated with sending a transaction, and you still need to pay this fee here, but you will be paying for it in the near side, not in the Aurora. And this fee was designed by Aurora, Aurora team, for the cases where users would like to send tokens from the Rainbow Bridge to the Aurora, and they wouldn't have the near tokens, near account ID. Like, they wouldn't basically be using near blockchain. They just would like to use the Aurora chain. However, it was actually never used like this. Aurora surveyor is sending those transactions to Aurora, so users don't actually need to pay for them. However, in general, that's the fee for those cases, because they wouldn't be able to pay the near transaction fee because they don't use near. So maybe they should pay some fee on the Aurora side in the Ether that's already on the Aurora.
So if I would be sending some tokens to you, then I decide what fee you should pay, right?
Yes, and this is the core of the vulnerability here, because as you can see here, both the recipient and the fee are encoded in the message, and message is one of the arguments provided within the transaction. This is fully in the control of whoever is sending the transaction, which means that it's fully in control of the attacker. So attacker chooses who will receive the tokens and how much fee they will that person will need to pay. So you can basically just make it a highest value possible and steal Ether from that person. Although there are some limitations to it.
What are the limitations? Could I steal all your money?
Yes, you could. You can, but not in the single transaction. In the single transaction, you actually are limited to the 18.4 Ether transfer. And that's because although the fee is parsed from the message that's 64 characters long, and it's parsed into the U256 type, then within the transfer, it's actually casted as an unsigned integer of 64 bits length. Which is way smaller. And if you would provide something that doesn't fit into the 64 bits, then it would basically, the Rust will panic and the whole transaction would fail. So you would just need to provide a smaller number, but then you can just execute the attack multiple times and still drain the funds of your target.
And considering that apart from getting the fee, I have to send you something, how much value have to be the tokens that I sent to you?
Absolutely nothing. You can, that's the very interesting part because this Aurora is permissionless and it is very easy to create your own tokens in the Aurora and create the mapping between them, between the token on the near side and the token on the in the Aurora. This is, anyone can do it. Without any additional authorization. So imagine a scenario that I create a meaningless token that I just will deploy to the new blockchain. Then I create one in the Aurora. I map between them, which I can do in a single transaction in the Aurora. And then I send you some tokens in the Aurora and say that you need to pay for them 18.4. Ether for the tokens that mean nothing to you and probably to anyone else.
And I have no way of preventing this, right?
No, you don't. No, you don't. This is the core of this vulnerability.
And so how was this fixed? Did they introduce some kind of verification for me to confirm the transaction?
Yeah, well, as I mentioned, in the regular operation, this fee was actually never not zero, which made it actually quite easy to fix this vulnerability because let me show you the fixed code. The Aurora team basically just manually set the fee to be zero at all times, and this is just a quick fix. But then later in the newest version, you will not see fee at all in this function. It was completely removed from the execution process.
So is there any meaningful recommendation you could give to any developers to not make such a mistake? It seems quite stupid to me, if I'm honest.
Yes, it does, because this was a flaw on the design level. Basically, as a rule of thumb in blockchain and probably not only in blockchain. If user didn't agree explicitly to something, don't make him pay for anything. So if, for instance, if this transaction would require the receiver to also sign this transaction somehow and explicitly say that they agree to receive the tokens, then in that case, there may be some scenario where this sort of mechanism would be meaningful. But basically, as a rule of thumb, you only take, like, the person who's paying for anything should be only the one who sends the transaction.
Okay. Thank you so much for explaining the bug. I'm happy that that it's been fixed, and I hope that as a white hat we will not see many of such mistakes done again.
Oh yeah, me too, for sure.
If you want to see the video that was the world's largest bounty to date, check out this one on your screen right now about the vulnerability in Polygon blockchain. For now, thank you for watching and goodbye.